Let's take a few minutes to discuss hitch settings and operation on John Deere tractors. Both midsize and large tractors offer four operating modes. They are position mode, draft control with slip sensitivity, and float mode. Position mode lowers the hitch to a set position and keeps it at that position regardless of draft loads. To activate position mode, first navigate to the hitch page by depressing the hitch button on the navigation bar. Change both load depth and slip sensitivity settings to zero. You can then adjust hitch position using either the hitch control lever or depth adjust dial. Depress the set button to save the hitch depth set position. Once a headland turn is completed, implement can be returned to the depth set position by placing the hitch lever into the lower detent position or simply by depressing the hitch resume button. Position mode is recommended when connected to non-ground engaging implements. It can also be used with ground engaging implements to maintain a constant depth, provided the terrain is flat and level. On the hitch page, you can also adjust upper limit position, indicated here with upper limit indicator, drop rate, or how fast the hitch will lower, and raise rate, or how fast the hitch will raise. Position mode, however, may not be your best choice when operating ground engaging implements in uneven or rolling terrain. With a hitch held at a fixed position in position mode, the implement will lift or pull out of the ground as the front wheels enter a trough. Then, implement is driven deep into the ground as front wheels exit the same trough. When operating in rolling fields or in fields where soil conditions change rapidly from soft to heavy soils, draft control mode may be a better choice. Draft control mode will automatically lower and raise the implement in rolling terrain to keep draft loads or implement load consistent. Also, in changing soil conditions from hard pan soil to soft soil, draft control mode will automatically raise and lower the implement to keep draft loads consistent. To activate draft control mode, first, adjust load depth setting to a setting somewhere between 1 and 5. The help page will provide suggestions for different types of implements. I would recommend starting out on the low end of these recommendations, using a setting of 1 to 2. Lower implement into the ground using a hitch control lever or depth adjust dial to achieve your desired depth. Then, while traveling at your desired depth and ground speed in average soil conditions for that field, depress the hitch set button. This records the hitch depth set position. However, while in draft control mode, it also records the current draft loads inputted by the hitch draft sensors. The hitch control unit will then lower and raise the hitch to maintain this same draft load. As this occurs, you will notice a difference between the actual hitch position and your original depth set position. A green bar displays the difference between depth set and actual hitch position. Load depth mode will also automatically prevent overloading of the tractor if soil density or resistance changes. When dense, hard soil conditions are encountered, it will raise the implement to keep the draft loads consistent, then lowering the implement when less dense soil or soft soils are encountered. If adjustments are made to load depth values, you must once again depress the set button while operating in normal field conditions at normal ground speeds. This will clear previous settings, then record and save new settings. Higher load depth values will cause more depth variations and faster draft response to load variations. If depth variations are too excessive, lower your load depth setting. If adjustments are made to load depth values, you must once again depress the set button while operating in normal field conditions at normal ground speeds. This will clear previous settings, then record and save new settings. Now let's discuss draft control with slip sensitivity. Slip sensitivity requires both load depth to be activated and a functional ground radar. Without one or both, slip sensitivity will be unavailable and grayed out on your display. Before using slip sensitivity, it is important to have your tractor properly ballasted to prevent excessive slip in normal conditions. Normal wheel slip for a properly ballasted wheel tractor is 8 to 12% slip, 2 to 5% for track tractors. Refer to operator's manual for more information on ballasting. With slip sensitivity activated, the implement will be raised if wheel slip is increased above your desired setting. It is then lowered back to the set position once wheel slip has decreased. As this setting is increased, the implement will be lifted with lower amounts of slip. Slip sensitivity can be deactivated by changing slip sensitivity settings to zero. Float mode is intended to be used with implements that are self-supporting with gauge wheels. Float mode allows the hitch to raise and lower with minimal resistance to allow the implement to follow the contour of the ground. To activate float mode, press hitch control lever full forward, then downward, locking it into the float position.